Roland, I want you to meet Julie Reams. She is Miss Disneyland Tencennial. This is Roland Crump, who for the project here is sort of acting as the interior decorator of a house of illusion. What do we call it?
Museum of the Weird.
Museum of the Weird.
It all started with a sketch. As early as 1951, Walt Disney had asked Harper Goff to begin designing a walk-through ghost house for what was becoming Disneyland. The process for creating this old house on a hill took a few takes. It began as an old dusty mansion off Main Street, a classically crooked and tattered place at the end of the lane. However, with budgetary and time constraints surrounding the opening of Disneyland, it was delayed and soon the design began to change with the location, as it was now being placed in the newly conceptualized New Orleans Square. After several interpretations, eventually Ken Anderson received some traction with his 1957 sketch on the project, but the exact look and placement kept being revised. Draft after draft, brick by brick, the mansion was getting put together.
I'll come right over here and I'll show you where you're going to meet the ghosts. This is a little scale model now that of the Disneyland area. You've seen this many times, but we haven't got the ghosts in there yet. But we're out collecting the ghosts. We're going to bring ghosts from all over the world. And we're making it very attractive to them, hoping, you know, they'll want to come and stay at Disneyland. So we're putting in wall-to-wall cobwebs, and we guarantee them creaking doors and creaking floors.
By 1959, the project was still searching for ideas. This is right when Raleigh Crump entered. He was a former assistant in animation, but after Disneyland opened, positions for the park, designers, and artists began to pop up more frequently for WED, which eventually became Imagineering. For them, he helped in designing the Adventureland Bazaar, and was instrumental in Disney's takeover of the 1964 World's Fair in New York. Walt wanted a large landmark marquee for It's a Small World attraction, and remembered that Raleigh had been working on mobiles and kinetic sculptures. The two began to discuss a larger scale version, and after Taggart and Cass Engineering was hired, the Tower of the Four Winds was born. Characters appeared there, and it was used as a symbol for Disney at the World's Fair. It also helped in establishing a foundation. The relationship that began with Walt Disney and Raleigh Crump on the tower transitioned into designing the attraction It's a Small World. Disney had initially brought on the recently retired Disney legend Mary Blair. She had begun early as a designer for the Disney animated features like Alice in Wonderland. Her character concepts were directly correlated to the work she had been doing on Little Golden Books. This, in conjunction with Raleigh Crump's perspective, allowed for a unique and iconic ride that Walt Disney was more than happy to introduce at the World's Fair on April 22, 1964. And while the Tower of the Four Winds was not taken to Disneyland, It's a Small World was, with Raleigh Crump, who was taken to design the new exterior based off of Mary Blair's work, bringing the attraction to Disneyland in 1966. After the dust settled on the World's Fair, everyone went back to the Haunted Mansion, which had settled squarely in purgatory. There were storylines of pirate captains and headless horsemen, but the real problem was, no one could settle on if it should be funny or scary. Mark Davis settled on the former.
Mark Davis is the master in charge of our House of Illusions, or what do we call it?
A Haunted Mansion.
Haunted Mansion and Supernatural.
Oh, lots
of
supernatural.
Can you give me a little idea what we're going to have in there?
His concept showcased a fun tour through a spooky but not scary old manor, and that pretty much became the thinking, that a ride was an old-style Cat and Canary haunted house. But there was also another way of viewing it. Raleigh Crump had an entirely different take on the project.
So I started doing some very bizarre sketches. I had Candleman, I had a gypsy wagon that came to life, I had man-eating plants, I developed a seance room, and I was doing all these sketches.
Crump had been designing a more non-traditional haunted house made of eerie, spooky things rather than just funny or scary. He was heavily influenced by two films.
Pour les grandes personnes qui n'ont pas perdu leur enfance.
The first being the 1946 Beauty and the Beast, and the second being Fellini's Juliet and the Spirits. He wanted to focus on more surreal things, like in those films. He had designed a coffin clock, a mirror to reveal your sins, an aquarium of dearly departed fish, and a mistress of evil who could become wholesome before breaking up into flames.
And everybody that was working at Wed at that time came out and they said, "You're not going to show those to Walt, are you?" And I said, "Well, yeah, he's not. I'm just having some fun, you know." And one of the fellows said, "Roy, do you mind if I sculpt some of those in a model form in maquettes?" And I said, "Yeah." So, I mean, we had that freedom just to kind of do whatever we want. Well,
Jack Fergus, who worked at Wed, took an interest and sculpted out a few of these designs that no one else particularly believed in.
Dick Irvine put everybody else onto the Haunted Mansion, and we were going to have a meeting with Walt on the Haunted Mansion. But nobody really thought my stuff was too weird. So what happened was when Walt came in, he came in the doorway, the table was here, and the three walls with all their other guys' artwork on it, and they stuck me over in the corner with the sculpting and the sketches and stuff. And so Walt sat down, and we had about a three-hour meeting with him on the Haunted Mansion, and finally he said, "Is that it?" And Dick Irvine didn't introduce me to talk to him about what I was doing, and they said, "Yeah, that's it." And he says, "What's this stuff in the corner?" I mean, that just shows you his peripheral vision. And they said, "That's something that Rolly did." And he said, "Well, what is it?" And they said, "Why don't you ask Rolly, because we don't know." And so he and I rolled our chairs over together and looked at it, and he said, "What is this?" And I told him the story about the films, and I felt that we should do something very different in the Haunted Mansion. And I said, "These are kids who be part of the architecture." And he says, "Yeah, but how would you do it?" And I said, I don't know. And so we got into this little session of, "Are you sure, Rolly?" And, "Well, I don't know." And it was kind of cute because everybody's sitting back there kind of smiling. And finally, Walt said, "I don't know. This stuff is really weird." And he got up and he left. Well, everybody said, "Rolly, we told you that the old man wouldn't necessarily buy that." And I said, "Yeah, I know, but I had a good time." I came to work the next morning, and Walt sitting in my chair at 7:30 in the morning, still wearing the same clothes he had on. And I walked in, I said, "Oh, hi, Walt." And he says, "Rolly," he says, "I just want you to know I didn't get an ounce of sleep last night because of what you showed me." And I said, "Really?" And he says, "Yeah, but I know how to use that." And I said, "You do?" And he said, "Yes." He says, "When we exit from the Haunted Mansion, we're going to build a museum of the weird where people can go through this museum and they can look at all the illusions and the crazy stuff that you've designed, and they can spend hours there, and we can do that."
These are going to be collected from all over the world, supposedly, and we're going to have man-eating plants, and we're going to have a coffin clock here that we're working on right now. We have a gypsy cart that comes to life with ghosts inside of it. We have a candle man. These are just things that are collected from all over the world, just the weirdest things we could find.
Yeah, we're also collecting real ghosts to bring here. You believe in ghosts, don't you, Julie?
No.
You don't?
Not really.
Well, let me take you over here and convince you that they do exist.
Of course, when he left, they all said, "You know, Rolly, we always thought that was a good idea." I thought, yeah.
All of this eventually resulted in an episode of Walt Disney's Wonderful World of Color, the 10th anniversary of Disneyland, which aired January 3rd, 1965. So, with Walt on board, a concept behind the pieces, and a better overall direction for the project, what happened? Why did the weirdness slip away until it became the Haunted Mansion we know today? Well, the answer's simple.
Walt Disney is dead tonight at the age of 65.
He had undergone surgery last month for removal of part of his left lung.
After his four Emmys, the Irving Thalberg Award.
Walt Disney, Hollywood's Prince of Fantasy.
After Walt passed away, the company became focused on just trying to complete the project without trying to add an additional museum. But most Imagineers will tell you, good ideas don't get thrown away. They get repurposed. And don't worry, the Museum of the Weird eventually did come to light when Marvel Unlimited released Disney Kingdom's Seekers of the Weird, where a group of teens must navigate the museum in order to save their parents. And while not everyone embraced the spirit of Rolly Crump's spirits, the idea and resources used in developing something like this give us an idea of the freedom and creative liberties the people making these rides had at the time, even if nobody was quite as weird as Rolly.